Let's take a look at another frequency distribution table. And this time, this data, exam data, is actually numerical values. This is quantitative. And my measurement scale here, you could argue as being either interval or ratio. I think you could have a successful argument for other, or for either. But the key here is that this is definitely quantitative. It's not qualitative. Now, the first thing I'm going to do here in this frequency distribution is I need to set up these categories. Well, when we're talking about quantitative data, they're no longer really referred to as a category because it's not categorical. We refer to this as a class. And I need to think about what's known as my class widths. In other words, when I make a histogram, another type of bar graph, how wide are those bars going to be? When it was A, B, C, D, the widths had to be the same, and they will be the same here. But the width was irrelevant when we did qualitative data. It doesn't matter how fat you make the A, B, C's, and D's, as long as you make them all the same. Here, it makes a big difference. Because these are exam scores, and it's on a scale from 0 to 100, and there are no 100s here, I'm going to make my first class start at 90. Be less than or equal to, and I will use an x as a variable, which is less than 100. If I had a perfect score of 100, I'd have another class up here of 100 to 110. Now, the reason being is when I look at this, anything greater than or equal to 90 will be in this class. My next one, I'll go down and say, all right, 80 is less than or equal to x, which is strictly less than 90. See, this has all of my 90s, this has all of my 80s. And then the next one, I would go to 70. It's less than 80, then 60s. And then 50s. And then, do I have this? I have 40s. And do I have any 30s in here? I do. I have at least one 30, so I need this group in here. See, now every single score will go into one and only one of these categories. So let's take a look at the 90s. See, this is 1, 2, 3. 4, 5. Did I miss anybody? I think that's it. So there were 5 in the 90s. So now let's look at the 80s. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oops, I missed one. 8. There's 8. And now the 70s. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. The 60s, see 1, 2, 3. 50s, there's 1, 2. The 40s, it looks like there's only one, and there's one in the 30s. So the relative frequency here, when I look at this, there's a total of 30 values. So the relative frequency will be 5 over 30, which I'm going to write as 16.67%. See, this time I'm going out a little bit farther rather than rounding. And then 8 would give me 26.67%. The 10 would give me a third, which is 33.33%. See, the 3 would give me 10%. The 2 would be a 6.67%. Here I'm running out at the second place, obviously. And then 1 would be 3.33%, and again 3.33%. Now, cumulative frequency, we'll do just the same as we did with the ordinal data. This will be 5 5 and 8 will give me 13, 10 more, 23, 3 more, 26, 2 more, 28, 1 more, 29, and 1 more, 30. Then, of course, the cumulative relative would be 5 out of 30. I will write this here this time, which is still 16.67%. And then the cumulative relative, this would be 13 out of 30, which is 43.33%. Then, of course, this is 23 out of 30. 76.66%. And then let me see, I have 26 out of 30, which is 86.66%. I guess technically, actually, I should, if I'm rounding at this second place, this should be a 7, and this would also be a 7 because the next value is a 6. And then 28 out of 30, 29 out of 30. And obviously the end, 30 out of 30, which is 100%. So see that 28 out of 30 is going to give me 93.33%. And then that last one, 29 out of 30, is going to give me 96.67%. And of course, this could easily be done with TC Stats. Now I want to produce a histogram. Now when I do this histogram, just as with qualitative data, I need to decide what's going to be on my vertical axis. Am I going to list the frequencies or the relative frequencies as percentages? Typically I list frequencies and then I include relative frequencies inside the graph. It's kind of a personal choice. So here, this would make more sense because this is numerical to list this starting with my 30s. Now, it's important here that these all have the same width. So I'll come up here and I'll start 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Now, to the best of my ability to draw, those are reasonably the same widths. Now, when I look at these frequencies, they go from a small of 1 to a large of 10. So it may make sense to make these by 1s. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And, of course, label them. And of course, over here on the side, I need to label this as being frequencies. I also need a graph. Again, I'm going to call this exam data. Or how about exam scores? That'd be better. And then down here, this is obviously the scores. Now, this low group, I had 1. In this next group, I also had 1. In the 50s, the 60s, I look up here, I had 2. Let me see if I get it. There we go. So 2 would be about here. And then the 60s, the 70s, I had 3. And then the 70s, the 80s, oops, there it is. 70, 80s, I had 10. And then in the 80s and 90s, I had 8. See, this one got a little bit fatter. That's not good because it makes it look like it's bigger than it really is. And then what's next? The 90s to 100s, I had 5. And then again, like I said earlier, it's a good idea to go back through and label these. So your reader has no doubt what they're looking at. And entering these individual percentages is also, I personally think, is a good idea. And so forth. So there you go. There's a complete histogram for this data. It has the proper labels, so we know what we're looking at. It has a title, so we know what this is about. This should be all equal widths. By hand, sometimes it's a little bit difficult to do, but we don't want to over-exaggerate. I listed the frequencies, and obviously I would continue with all those relative frequencies. And here is the exact same histogram created with these class widths of 10 using TC Stats. And I chose to indicate both the frequencies and the relative frequencies displayed on each so that a reader can look at it and very quickly understand completely what's going on there.